Today I'm going to be showing you 6 different Tumblr inspired DIY room decors, and I hope you guys enjoy it, so let's just jump right in. For this first one, all you're going to need is a plastic bottle, some scissors, a Sharpie, and some acrylic paint. The first thing you have to do is take your Sharpie and draw the outline of your plant pot, and I've chosen a cat, so here I'm just drawing the ears, and I'm using the first sort of indent of the bottle as a guideline for how tall I want the plant pot to be. Then I'm taking my scissors and just cutting the outline out. This is kind of tricky, but please be careful not to cut yourself and try to be as neat as possible with it. Then I'm taking some white acrylic paint and a little sponge, and I'm just covering the whole thing in a stippling motion. No matter how hard I try. And then I mixed some red and white paint and I went in with little triangles for the ears and the nose for the cat. Then I'm taking some black acrylic paint and I'm drawing out the mouth, the eyes, and the little cute whiskers. And that is it. I think this looks super cute in a shabby chic room especially, and you can put any plant in it. I've put in my little cactus and I think it looks adorable. This next one is very simple. All you need is a few pebbles from a garden or a park, whichever, and some acrylic paint. What you're gonna do is paint every single pebble in a desired pattern or design, and then you're gonna be putting all of those pebbles in a little clear jar. You can get crazy and as creative as you want to be with this. Literally use any colors you like and any patterns you want to create. So here's the final look. I think it looks super unique. It's a very easy and very cheap DIY. I think the colors can spice up any room. This next one is super easy but very effective. All you need is a light bulb that's been hollowed out, and then you need a little cap and a chosen flower. I'm going to be using the cap as a little holder for the bulb, and I'm filling the bulb with some water. I'm then taking the flower and simply just popping that in the light bulb. And that is all. I think this looks so cute and it's very interesting. It's very different. So yeah, that's how you do it. This next one isn't a tutorial, it's more of an idea. I have had this guitar in my room for ages and I painted it myself just using some white acrylic paint, and then I've painted some daisies on it. Now for this one, what you're gonna need is some empty glass bottles. The ones I've used are from like cooking oil, and then you're gonna need some acrylic and a little sponge. So here I'm just placing some blue and white paint on a piece of paper, and I'm also cutting the sponge in half just because it was a little bit too big, and then I'm just mixing the two shades together to get a very light blue color. Then I'm taking that blue color and I'm just stippling that on with my sponge onto the bottle. I'm going to be creating a little gradient by taking the lightest shade of blue on the top and then placing a slightly darker shade of blue on the bottom of the bottle. Taking some red and white paint and I'm just mixing that together to create a pale pink, and I'm doing the same effect on this bottle. So that is all. I think they look super cute, especially if you pop in a lavender flower of some sort. For this next one, all you're gonna need is some jars, acrylic paint, a paintbrush, a pen, some Pritt stick and some scissors, and also some paper. So the first thing I'm doing is folding the paper in half, and I'm drawing an outline of a heart, only half of it, because we're gonna cut it out and make sure that it's very symmetrical. That's why we've folded the paper in half. Then I'm taking my Pritt stick and we're gonna be gluing the little heart onto our jar. I'm holding on Then I'm taking some black paint and I'm just proceeding to cover the whole jar with this. Be very careful around the edges though, because the paint can still get underneath the heart. To achieve a neat finish, I recommend doing the brush strokes all in the same direction. It's just going to look much more effective and neater in the end. The words that I sent to you, never forgotten to you, no matter how hard I try. Then I'm taking a hairdryer and just speeding up the process of drying the jars, and then all I'm doing is just peeling off the little hearts. Now you will have some residue from the glue that we applied, so I'm just taking a makeup remover and a little earbud, and then I'm just wiping all the excess glue off. Next, I'm taking some white acrylic paint and just creating a stitch effect all around the heart for a little accent. Next, I'm taking some white string and just wrapping that around the jar just for a nice little finish, and I'm wrapping that up in a bow. So that is all for my tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed this and thank you for watching. I'll see you in my next one.